Hi, today I'm going to be talking about sustainable denim. Kind of seems like an oxymoron just because when it comes to jeans and other clothing items made out of denim, it's a really energy and resource intensive fabric to make. Denim is just like it uses a lot of water, a lot of energy. It's not particularly sustainable. And so, if you're going to buy anything, I think it's great to search for sustainable clothing when you can afford it. But if you're on a bit of a budget and you're looking for certain items of clothing that you'd like to upgrade and buy from ethical, eco-friendly brands, jeans would be a really good place to do that. But firstly, I want to point out, as I do in many of my sustainable fashion videos, that the most sustainable choice is wearing what you already own and not buying new. I'm just talking about if you're in the market for needing to replace a pair of old jeans, or if you need a new size and that's why you're looking for new jeans, or any other reason where you feel like you do need to bring a new item of clothing in your closet. Then either check out some of these brands that I'm going to mention or thrift. Secondhand clothing is a great option. I've talked about it many, many times, and actually, I'll get to this later, but some of the jeans that I have from these brands, I have thrifted. The first brand that I wanted to talk about is called Boyish. And if you've heard of the extremely popular sustainable brand Reformation, Boyish is kind of connected to that. I believe that the person who created this brand, Boyish, used to work at Reformation and do the denim for Reformation, and now they have created their own brand of jeans. They don't only have jeans, they sell shirts as well, and like denim skirts and denim dresses, denim jackets. And as for pretty much all of the brands I'm going to talk about today, they are on the expensive side, but they are by no means the most expensive brand I'm going to talk about. I feel like a lot of these jeans are like $120, and I do have a pair. And I'll show a clip of what they look like, but they're like a medium wash, straight leg, fairly high rise, I would say. And I actually thrifted these. I searched for Boyish denim online, thrifted, and I was able to find a pair in my size. Well, they're actually one size too large. I probably should have gone down, but I'd rather have them be a little bit too big on me than be too small to actually fit. And Boyish actually has something that Redone has and is pretty well known for, which is like a consignment shop, I guess. Like they will buy your Boyish jeans back and then you can purchase from their website, like the consignment shop of used Boyish jeans at a cheaper price, which is very cool. And I like that they're promoting recycling clothing in that way. They're also part of 1% for the Planet and something called One Tree Planted, like planting one tree for every order, I believe is how that works. Other things that they do when it comes to sustainability, honestly, I feel like with most jeans brands, they just have nothing about the process at all. So even to have like a sustainability section talking about what they're doing to make these jeans as best they can is a promising sign. They use plant-based dyes rather than synthetic dyes. They recycle water to keep chemicals out of fresh water. And the fabric mills and factories that they work with are really well rated and interested in advancing water safety in the textile industry. They dip their fabric fewer times to conserve energy and water. They're also cruelty-free, PETA approved, no leather or any other animal products in their clothes. Recycled cotton, dead stock fabrics. They use Tencel, which is known for being a pretty sustainable fabric. They have a whole page where they go through all of their sustainability and ethical efforts to make sure that their jeans are made the best they can, and I really appreciate that. As far as style goes as well, they have a variety of jeans that are very cool. They've got distressed, non-distressed, skinny, straight, flare, baggy, high-rise, mid-rise. I don't know if they have any low-rise, but a big variety, so surely there is some style that you would like. The next brand I want to talk about is Nudie Jeans. They actually make jeans for both men and women, which is nice. They've got that variety. And I don't have any pairs of jeans from this brand, but maybe down the road, if I feel like I want to buy more jeans, I would consider them. They definitely have some good practices as far as fair wages and ethical treatment of their workers, as well as trying to ensure that all of their products have at least 70% sustainable fabrics. I believe they've actually won some sort of sustainable fashion award, which is very cool as well. And I think the price range of these is similar to Boyish, maybe like $130 for a pair is about what they run. Again, if you're not interested in paying that high of a price, try and see if you can thrift them, like I did with the Boyish jeans. Oh, as well, they do offsetting carbon emissions. They offset their business's full emissions through the UN's Carbon Offset Program. Like to see that. They have some pretty cool styles as well, similar to like the vein of Boyish. I feel like Nudie jeans are maybe a little bit less trendy. They're pretty like timeless, like classic styles of jeans, I would say, which is good because you want to buy a pair of jeans and not have to replace them for a really long time. Most of the jeans I've had for like close to 10 years at this point, and you want them to be having that really long lifespan since you don't want to be buying jeans on a regular basis. The next brand I wanted to mention is Warp and Weft. This denim brand prides themselves on being size inclusive. Very cool. Like to see it. And they have a whole section on their website where they talk about the eco-friendly processes that they have in place, from sourcing and managing the cotton that they use to make the jeans up to the way that they treat their workers and wages and production and all that. They have it all laid out on their website. I love when companies are more transparent about that type of thing rather than just leaving it up to you to guess. They provide the information, which is great. I know it's laid out in marketing-friendly language, but still, I appreciate that they have their practices included for you to read through. This brand is a little bit cheaper, actually, on their prices. I don't think I've seen a pair over $100 for denim, which I think is really great. As far as like a sustainability brand, these are definitely lower prices compared to what I've seen. And not just for jeans, just for brands in general. Like, I feel like finding pieces under $100 can sometimes be difficult when you're looking at these types of clothing brands. I feel like a lot of their stuff is like in the $80 to $90 range. Still not cheap, but cheaper than other companies that I've talked about. And again, like I mentioned, they have a good range of sizes. Like, they have like different models of different sizes shown on the website, which is nice to see a variety compared to just all size two. I also wanted to talk about DL1961, which is a very cool brand. A lot of brands are doing this thing where they like take recycled plastic water bottles and turn them into clothing, and this is one of those brands. I just think that's so cool. They're using recycled plastic bottles as well as recycled denim and turning that into jeans, which is amazing. Great use of resources. They have one statistic where like a typical pair of jeans takes 1,500 gallons of water to make, which doesn't surprise me. Jeans are really water intensive. They claim that theirs only takes 10 gallons of water, which is amazing. They are a bit higher on the price range, unfortunately, rather than like Boyish and Nudie jeans being similar price, Warp and Weft being a little bit cheaper. These guys are closer to like the $200 range of jeans, which honestly, like, I know that sounds like a lot, but there are plenty of brands out there that have no sustainability efforts at all and are charging $200 for their jeans. So if you're going to pay a lot for jeans, you may as well get them from a company that's trying to do right by the planet than like some other like higher fashion brands that are making expensive jeans and seem to have no interest in trying to use recyclable materials or anything like that. As far as styles go, again, I think they have a pretty good range when it comes to different rises, different fits, different washes and colors, amounts of distressing. So I feel like there's lots of different options. Any type of style that you prefer, they probably have it. I actually personally really like the look of these jeans. If I were to want to buy them someday, I would probably try and thrift them first if I could find them, but I just do really like their styles, and I like their sustainability practices as well. Now, I'm finally going to talk about Redone, which is probably the sustainable denim brand that everybody has heard of. It's very popular. They're known for taking old denim, particularly Levi's, and reworking them into new jeans, which is great. Similar to what DL1961 does. And I think they did it first, I'm pretty sure. I don't know. But Redone is known for taking vintage Levi's and creating new jeans out of them and giving them new life. Some of their jeans kind of have that look of like patchwork denim, like they look pieced together from old jeans. And well, I think that's very cool. It's not exactly a timeless look. They do have other denim that looks more, it's not as like trendy looking. I do have a pair of Redone jeans that I fairly recently purchased, and Redone is known for being pretty expensive. Their jeans are anywhere between $200 and up to $300. I think they're the most expensive brand that I'm going to mention in this video, but I of course did not buy them from Redone. I found them online thrifting, just searched for Redone jeans in my size, and I got this pair actually. I looked for a particular style as well. I wanted to get these, I think they're called 70s stovepipe, like this lighter wash. They're not really distressed. They have a couple of small areas, like at the bottom hem, they look a little bit distressed. I will say, as expensive as they are, they certainly feel, even compared to the Boyish jeans, which are amazing, these Redone jeans feel, they're actually brand new. When I got them from the seller, they still had all of the tags on them. Brand new jeans, and I got these for $100, I think. So basically, over 50% off because I searched for them thrifting. But I like doing like double sustainable, like searching for a sustainable brand secondhand. I just feel like that's the best impact. And they just feel thick, they're stiff, they're not stretchy, so beware. They actually do have a brand, or not a brand, a line of jeans that do have stretch in them because most of their jeans are very stiff like this. These just, they feel like they're gonna last me 100 years. They're just so like thick and high quality. I understand why Redone has like a good reputation for being that type of jean. Hopefully I'll have these for a very long time and I won't like gain or lose any weight that I wouldn't be able to fit them anymore, because I do really like them. They also have some really great styles. They're just known for being like on-trend, fashionable brand of jeans that are high quality as well as sustainable because they're using recyclable fabrics. Now, the next two brands that I want to talk about are kind of similar, similar price point and similar business model of jeans. They make jeans to order, which is sustainable in kind of a different way. Like, rather than just pumping out jeans and having jeans waiting to be bought and like potentially creating waste by making jeans that aren't going to be purchased, they make their jeans specifically fit to you. Like, you answer all these questions and you take a bunch of your measurements and you tell them if you want like this length or how high you want the rise to be. You choose the style that you want, and then they make the jeans custom made for you. And the two brands are Lasso and Sen Studio or Scene Studio. Maybe it's Sen. I'm not sure. But they both have that same model where you tell them how you want them to fit and you give them all their measurements, and they only make a pair when a pair is ordered. So in that way, these are both really not wasteful denim brands because they're not just pumping out pairs of jeans. They're waiting specifically to make it for you, which I haven't ordered from either of these before, but it's really tempting because, like, how could you make a pair of jeans fit more perfectly if they're going based on exactly your body shape and your measurements? It sounds like there's no reason why these shouldn't be the best fitting pair of jeans you ever buy. And compared to like Redone or a lot of other brands, these are pretty affordable, I would say, for a custom pair of jeans. Like Lasso is just under $200, which again is not cheap, but you're getting a pair of jeans that's made for you. So you could get a pair of jeans from any of these other brands, and that would probably be a great choice. But it's definitely tempting to pay a similar amount and get a custom pair of clothing, which is very cool. Sen Studio is a little bit cheaper, more like $150 for a pair of jeans. I think Lasso is like $180, $190 maybe. So both of these I definitely think are doing something very cool and would recommend. Would like to try them myself someday. But those are all of the sustainable denim brands I wanted to talk about. If there are any others that you think are doing really great things, let me know. I'd like to look into them and know about them. And thanks for watching.